What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, three-division, former world champion, British superstar boxer, Amir King Kong, who finished his career, or is, should I say, semi-retired. The last time we've seen Amir Kong grace the square circle is when he had a showdown with Billy Dibbs back in July of 2019. And that was like a, you know, exhibition bout. You know, it was a real fight, but it was exhibition feel. Last time we saw him in a real meaningful fight is when he took on undefeated three-division world champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, and currently the WBO welterweight world champion, and widely considered the number one pound-for-pound boxer in the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. That took place in April of 2019. Which Amir Khan essentially quit in the fight. Terrence Crawford got the TKO victory, but Amir Khan essentially quit in that fight. Amir Khan right now record stands at 34-5 with 21 by way of knockout. He himself was knocked out four times in his career. He was knocked out, cold by Danny Garcia. He was knocked out by Bredis Prescott early in his career. Knocked out cold by Saul Canelo Alvarez. And he was TKO'd by Terrence Bud Crawford in a fight that most people feel like he just simply quit in that fight. With that said, Amir Khan and his former rival opponent, Terrence Bud Crawford, are at odds at what's going to take place in Terrence Crawford's next fight. And his next fight will be against Amir Khan's fellow countryman and natural rival in Kell Brook. Former IBF welterweight world champion, British superstar boxer, who's been campaigning to get a showdown with Amir Khan, oddly enough, and Amir Khan will not give Kell Brook the fight. This is a fight that would have been massive in the UK, but he simply just chose not to ever give Kell Brook this fight. Kell Brook is 34 years of age. He used to be IBF welterweight world champion. He lost that title when Errol "The Truth" Spence Jr., now undefeated unified WBC IBF welterweight world champion superstar boxer, came over and stepped foot on his soil in the UK and took the strap up off of Kell Brook's waist when he stopped Kell Brook in their fight and broke Kell Brook's eye socket. Kell Brook has a record of 39-2, 27 by way of knockout. He himself was stopped twice when he dared to be great, jumping up two weight classes from 147 to 160 to challenge then what was seen as the pound-for-pound top five, top three fighter in the world, unified, undefeated, middleweight, reigning champion, Gennady Triple G Golovkin, who was on an absolute tear knocking out all his opponents. Kell Brook dared to be great when Gennady Golovkin was looking for an opponent. He chose to go up, Gennady Golovkin, we know the outcome. Gennady Golovkin broke his eye socket and stopped him. And in the very next fight, he got stopped by Errol Spence Jr. So with that said, you know, Kell Brook is 34 years of age, and he has been campaigning to get a fight with Amir Khan. Amir Khan won't give him the fight. And now we know why. Amir Khan is picking Kell Brook to beat the pound-for-pound best fighter in the world and Terrence Bud Crawford. He says he has all the tools to do so, not just because he's my fellow countryman, but he is naturally my rival. So, you know, we have a built-in rivalry. So, you know, it's not that I'm just favoring him because he's my countryman. He says, I will be rooting for him because he's my fellow countryman. I will be backing him because he's my fellow countryman. But simply because he has the skill set, the size and the strength and the ability, as long as he could comfortably make 147, he will beat Terrence Crawford. I shared the ring with Terrence Crawford. I know what abilities Kell Brook have because I sparred with Kell Brook. That's where their rivalry brewed from. That's where it stemmed from, right? Everybody says that Amir Khan got the best of Kell Brook in the sparring session. Some people are saying Kell Brook got the best of Amir Khan in it. And it started to brew a natural rivalry between the two. And we thought we was going to get this showdown, the boxing world, the boxing fans, and the boxing pundits thought that we was going to get this all-British showdown. It would have been a massive fight. It still would be a massive fight in UK soil, but we never got it. We never see it come to fruition. And Kell Brook has been pushing for this fight, but Amir Khan just not willing to give it to him. So Amir Khan is saying that he understands the skill set that Kell Brook has. He's been in the ring with Terrence Crawford, and he's picking Kell Brook to win this fight as long as he comfortably makes 147. And the reason he's saying that is because after Errol Spence stopped Kell Brook in, back in 2017, Kell Brook cited that his loss to Errol Spence was due to the fact that he came down from 160 and went down all the way to 47, a 13-pound decrease he had to take, you know, he had to go through. And he cited that being the reason. And then he started the campaign at junior middleweight at 154. He said that was his best weight. He even invited Errol Spence to come to 154. And he said, I'll be victorious there. I'm much stronger and, you know, I have more energy, so on and such. Now Kell Brook is saying he could comfortably make 147 once again 3 years later. And so a lot of people question if he'll be able to do so, right? Is that going to play a factor? But not Amir Khan. He's saying that Kell Brook will win this fight. You know, Kell Brook did beat Showtime Sean Porter, but it was a lot of excessive holding in that fight. He did, have much success against Gennady Triple G Golovkin until he started getting hit and hurt. But Kell Brook, in my opinion, he was making it a close fight with Errol Spence as well, until Errol Spence started to break him down. And that's where I cite Terrence Crawford to be successful in this fight, because he starts to fade. Kell Brook is a big, strong, strapping guy. He has he's high skill set, you know, very disciplined, and he's very technical, right? But he could be very robotic at times, and he could be very predictable. He has a great jab, but he tends to use the 1-2 a lot. You know, he can go to the body when he so chooses, but he's slower than Terrence Crawford. And oddly enough, Errol Spence is slower than Terrence Crawford, and so is Gennady Golovkin. But they found their target. And so Terrence Crawford having a speed advantage, I think that Errol Spence is maybe a little more precise with his punches than Terrence Crawford, but Terrence Crawford is very accurate with his punches. Errol Spence is more technical, where he breaks you down in levels, right? Body, head, body. You know, Terrence Crawford is going to take what you give him, and he's going to take it fast. You understand? Like, Terrence Crawford, you know, is going to take the opportunities you give him. Errol Spence is going to you know, he's going to force himself on you. He's going to dictate what you give him. You understand? Gennady Golovkin is more so like, Errol Spence in that sense, where they're very technical in the ring, and they're pressure, and they're going to force you to fight their fight, right? Terrence Crawford will fight your fight, and he'll take what you give him. So the mistakes you make, he's going to capitalize on them. Errol Spence is not going to capitalize on the mistakes you make. He's going to force you to make mistakes, right? He's going to force himself on you. He's going to force his will upon you, right? And just break you down in levels. He's just going to keep coming like a machine. Terrence Crawford is going to do it in a different manner. Terrence Crawford is going to make you pay for every little mistake you make mentally, okay? So you mentally thinking. He's going to make you play a thinking man's game, where if you throw the jab, he's going to counter it. He might be in the orthodox stance. He might be in the southpaw stance, right? He might fight you on the inside. He might fight you from the outside. Errol Spence walked Kell Brook down from the opening bell and just was looking to break him down. So was Gennady Golovkin. The difference is Kell Brook was having more success against Gennady Golovkin than he did Errol Spence. Now, it was a very close fight with Errol Spence and Kell Brook, because that was Errol Spence's first rodeo on that big stage. And I think that, you know, he was a little tight, and he was going back in the high guard in a straight line when Kell Brook was offensive. So that allowed Kell Brook to have a lot of success. When Errol Spence started to make the adjustments in the second half of the fight, he just simply broke Kell Brook down and stopped him. Now, I will say this, when you have that type of eye injury, you're susceptible to having the other eye injured as well. And Errol Spence, you know, took full advantage of that as well. Thus, he stopped Kell Brook. So, you know, I think that Terrence Crawford's accuracy and the fact that Kell Brook now has two injured eyes. So it's not that you could target the injured eye. Now they're both injured. So it doesn't matter where Terrence Crawford lands. You know, there's a possibility that there could be, you know, injury, you know, occurring and a reoccurrence of that eye injury. Not to mention stamina is going to be a factor, because regardless of how great he feels he made the weight, and how comfortable he feels he got down to 47, it's still going to play a part in 12-round fight with somebody giving you some serious feedback. It's one thing to do it in sparring. It's one thing to do it in a controlled atmosphere. It's a whole nother ball game when you're doing it in a manner where you can't predict the outcome. You can't control the atmosphere. Your trainers, your coaches can't control the atmosphere, right? They can't dictate what your sparring partner is doing or what they want him to do. They can't simulate that. This is Terrence Crawford, you know, coming in unorthodox, coming using angles, southpaw orthodox, stance, and, you know, very accurate, and could be a dog on the inside or fight you, outbox you from the outside. So I think that Amir Khan is being a homer right now. I think that Amir Khan, and he did state this, he wants Kell Brook to end Terrence Crawford's reign. So that lets me know that he's a little bitter behind the fact that he got in the ring with Terrence Crawford, and everybody was saying Amir Khan has never been outboxed and he's never lost at 147. Well, see, the thing is about that is this. Terrence Crawford was outboxing him, beating him to the point. He dropped him early in the fight. And I feel like in that fight, Amir Khan started to feel like, wait a minute, I'm in there with a more superior boxer. I'm in there with a guy that's just as quick as I am, but he's more versatile than I am. And I think that Amir Khan was looking for a way out. And I think that didn't sit right as a competitor, as a combat athlete. In his gut, it didn't sit right. And so he's picking against Terrence Crawford, right? He's being a homer. And he would love Kell Brook to win, because here's why. If Kell Brook beats Terrence Crawford, miraculously, Amir Khan is going to want to fight Kell Brook in a massive fight in the UK, right? He knows he has a better opportunity and a better chance to beat Kell Brook because of Kell Brook's skill set, how he matches up with Kell Brook's skill set than he does with Terrence Crawford's skill set. So he will have a chance, and it will be an all-British showdown on UK soil, and it will be massive. And Kell Brook is now a two-time world champion, and Amir Khan accomplishments, and you see they could overblow it, right? You understand? So you see where I'm getting at with this. Terrence Crawford is going to beat Kell Brook. I think Terrence Crawford is going to stop Kell Brook by the eighth, ninth round. I believe that by the ninth round, Kell Brook will be getting stopped in this fight. And Terrence Crawford will be looking to go sign with the PBC, Premier Boxing Champions, and have a massive showdown, I believe, with Showtime Sean Porter, two-time welterweight world champion superstar boxer. And then he'll make his way either to Manny Pacquiao or Errol Spence Jr. So I think that Amir Khan is coming from a place of being a homer and a place of bitterness because of how he lost with Terrence Crawford. And I think that in that fight, subconsciously, he understands to himself that he threw in the towel mentally, subconsciously. He called it was a low blow, he said, and that was the reason he couldn't continue. I've seen guys get hit with far worse low blows than the one Amir Khan was hit with, and they continued on, a la Riddick Bowe and Andrew Golota. So drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Buddy Sports TV. Hey, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Buddy Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.